to deliver this statement on behalf of the non-aligned movement. The non-aligned movement views the general debate under agenda item 10 as an essential platform for states to share their visions and views to promote more effective technical cooperation and capacity building in the field of human rights. It's also a good opportunity for states to share concrete experiences, challenges, and information on the assistance needed in the implementation of their human rights obligations and commitments, as well as the recommendations they have accepted in the Universal Periodic Review process. The NAM recalls that providing advisory services, technical and financial assistance at the request of the state concerned and with a view to supporting their actions and programs in the field of human rights is one of the responsibilities of the High Commissioner for Human Rights and her office. Technical assistance and capacity building also constitute an essential component of the work of the Human Rights Council. The NAM emphasizes that the enhancement of international cooperation aimed at strengthening the capacity of states is essential for the effective promotion and protection of human rights and implementation of the 2030 Sustainable Development Agenda. In this regard, the NAM is of the view that both the Human Rights Council and the Office of the High Commissioner for Human Rights should redouble their efforts in providing advisory services, capacity building, and technical assistance to states upon their request and according to their national needs and priorities to ensure the realization of all universally recognized human rights and fundamental freedoms. In conclusion, we reiterate that all human rights, including the right to development, are universal, inalienable, indivisible, interdependent, and interrelated. With this in mind, the technical cooperation and capacity building activities by the Human Rights Council and the Office of the High Commissioner for Human Rights should have an equal focus on civil, political, economic, social, and cultural rights. I thank you, Mr. Vice President.